Hey there, ServiceNow heroes. Welcome back to our channel TechnoNow, where we turn ServiceNow concept into superpower you can use every day. Today, we are diving into the world of Catalog Data Lookup Definition. Okay? I'm pretty sure most of you are not using it out or they haven't heard about it also. Okay? Alright, before we jump into the fun stuff, okay, let's quickly cover the basics. Okay? What is a Catalog Data Lookup Definition in ServiceNow? So, Catalog Data Lookup Definition ServiceNow is a no-code feature that lets you automatically populate fields in catalog item based on data from another table. Okay, so you will not get what exactly I am saying for now. So, let's try to look into it with some example. So, I will just go to maintain items. And, maintain items. And here I have created one catalog item called meat. Okay, so basically this is what I was creating for Pune meetup. Okay, but it didn't work out, but I can use it out for the demo purpose for now. So this particular meat catalog item has a variable set, and if I open this particular variable set, let's see. It has three variables, and basically we create a variable set so that we can reuse it out again and again. And this kind of variable set, right, where we have requested for email ID and mobile number, it's kind of a generic use case. So basically you requested for is a reference field, which is referencing to the user table. Then we have string fields called email ID and mobile number. Now, what use case we have is like, if I open this particular catalog item, right, if we see this particular catalog item, if I do try it, okay. So this is how the form looks like. And if I select someone over here, okay. So if I select able tutor over here, so I have general expectation from this. I think I should make it this also read only. So our expectation out of it is like, it should pre-fill auto populate email ID and mobile number, right? Okay. This is a generic requirement from every we get on a day-to-day basis. So what we generally do in this kind of use case, we write a script include, which is client callable, then we write a catalog client script, then we do GlideAjax. From GlideAjax, we pull out the values, then populate it out, so and so forth. Then we have to do it on load, on chain, and a lot of mess out there, okay? So what if I tell you that we don't have to do these things, right? Okay, and we have a feature already provided by ServiceNow, because ServiceNow know this is a hack, right? Called Catalog Data Lookup. So how exactly it works? So for today, the use case is like, based on requested for, we have to fill email ID and mobile number. That's it. So how we can do it without doing any code? Okay. So what I will do, I'll just go to configure item. And over here, we have a variable set, right? So we will just open this particular variable set. Now, you can see there are variables out there, then there are catalog UI policies, so on and so forth. But there is something called Catalog Data Lookup Definition. Anyone of you have looked into that? If yes, you are lucky. So, what we can do here, we can define the relationship between all the fields, okay? And what is the source table, okay, from where it's getting fetched. And based on that, it will get auto-populated. So, how we can do that? So, I will create a new Catalog Data Lookup Definition. And let's give it a name as user details. My bad. User details applies to variable set. Currently, I have variable set, so I'm using it applies to variable set. But you can do the same if all the variables are there on the catalog item. Okay. But for now, I will select a variable set. And which variable set? So you can select over here. So it was user details variable set, right? And now we have to give it the information from which particular day. A table this particular data is referencing to. So we know it's coming from sys user table. So I will just select, well, that sys user table. Sys user table. And here you can see run on form change also. So if you are not checking this particular checkbox, it will be on load. Okay. But if you check this checkbox, whenever you change any value, it will also get changed. Isn't it amazing, right? So you have to just save this out. Simple, right? Now, as soon as you save it, you get two related lists down there. What is the catalog matchup variable definition? This is where you can define what is the source of the information. So if I click new over here, for us, the source of information is the variable called requested for, right? Because based on this, we have to fill mobile number and email address, right? If you don't do exact lookup match, it will have star query kind of thing, okay? But I will do an exact lookup match and match a table field. So what field it has a relationship with? So requested for is a reference field which gives sys ID, right? So it has a relationship with the user ID. With the sys ID on the sys user table. From where this information is coming? Because we have defined a sys user table as a source table for the matcher. But then we have defined the source. That's it. Submit. Now we have another. So this is catalog setter variable definition. Here you can define the target fields. So if I select over here, again, which particular field? So it's email ID we have to fill. And which particular field it resonates with on the sys user table? So it's email, right? And this is quite amazing. Okay, it's always replaced. If you check this particular checkbox, whenever a person tries to manipulate that value, it will again get replaced. Okay, so it will not allow you to change anything. And if you are not checking this particular checkbox, okay, it will allow you to manipulate the data. But we don't want to manipulate that data, right? Because we want the user email ID itself. So we'll just do always replace, submit. In the similar way, we will have one more, and that is mobile number. Okay. What field it resonates with on sys user table? It's mobile phone. And we'll again do all. Is based on your use case. Okay, you can choose whatever you want to do. Done. And you have just bypassed the entire GlideAjax. What if I say you have literally bypassed the entire GlideAjax thing? You don't believe me, right? Okay. So if I go now and if I go to the meet catalog item, okay, and if first I have to check, right, what user is holding both the values. So what I will do, I'll just do user, mobile number, okay, this pillars it. So I'll just copy this name, okay, I will just go back to meet, and if I select now this particular user, this, it should auto-populate these values. Done. No need of writing GlideAjax and also and so forth. And if I manipulate it out, okay, if I try to manipulate it out, it will again get replaced with the actual value. Isn't it amazing? So if you are using GlideAjax, just delete it out, throw it in a dustbin, and you can start using catalog data lookup definitions now onwards. Okay, this is a very simple use case. Okay, but you can elaborate it out, you can enhance it out to the way you want. So this is all for today's tutorial. I hope you like it out. Okay, please like, follow my channel. Okay, in order to get the new video update. Till then, stay safe, stay happy, and have a nice day ahead. Thank you.